Hello, hello everybody, Felicia here with another video for CutCardStock. I am on their design team. I'm going to be working with some quilling and I just wanted to kind of give you an idea of what I will be working with here. And what I did was, as you can see here, I pre-cut everything and had it all ready to go. And then it took me a little bit of time to pre-cut a lot of stuff, but I'm using a lot of the cardstock for the greenery part. And you can see here that I've cut them all in strips and I got all my tools ready and everything. So anyway, so I sped this up because it was something I wanted to hurry up and kind of get past. But when I go to the very next section, you will see how I kind of slow it down a little bit so you can see the process of it all. But I use the cut cardstock, and the colors that I'm using here, once again, is the chartreuse. And there you saw a picture of me kind of rolling the paper there. Is the chartreuse metallic, which I'm really happy, and the gold leaf metallic. So those are the two colors that I'm using here. And I'm using those two colors here on the, as the stems of the flowers, because they're, it's nice and stiff. And I love that. Oh my gosh, it just worked out so good to have that that cardstock. And that cardstock does really well, by the way. Even when you're twirling it, it does really well. You know how some cardstocks kind of break apart and stuff and kind of don't do right, or they won't do bend to the will of what you want them to. With the cut cardstock it does do that, and it did very well when I rolled up the ends of the stems that are being used as the flower stems here of here. Sorry about that. I kind of on the layout here. Sorry about that double taco. I almost forgot what I was saying. Anyway, so I quilled a lot of pieces because I wanted to make sure that the flowers looked like, you know, at least resembled a little bit of flowers and stuff. I have no idea what kind of flowers these are. I just made them, so they're not really anything in specific. It's just something that I wanted to make into some kind of like bouquet-ish type of deal thing here, as you can see. And each one of these pieces, and one of the reasons why I did speed this up, because it took a lot of time to glue these down, more time than you're actually seeing right now. For some reason, I don't know why, but it just did. So, like I said, I've used the cardstock as stems for the flowers, for the base of the flowers, and then I used the bottom, I used the cardstock here as part of the background, and of course, as part of the bottom part where you see where the scalloped pieces of paper are at the bottom here, the layout. So right now I'm finishing up kind of gluing up these pieces here, and like I said, I'm really glad that I went pretty fast in this section because it took a long time for me to glue these things down. And so there you see me rolling up some more of these stems there, as you can see how easy that was. And I left that in there so you could see that. It was very easy to roll this cardstock. And then also what I loved about it is that you could bend the cardstock to any direction that you wanted it to. As you can see, I'm taking my finger kind of running along, giving it a little bit of a curve, and I'm curving some like inwards and then some going the other direction. And you can see how easy it is for me to do that. It just takes a little rundown with my finger. This, I'm loving this cardstock, you guys. You have no idea how much I'm really loving this. So it's working out pretty good. And I'm glad that they made really good stems. Now you're gonna see me struggle. Only part you're gonna see me struggle here was I forgot to glue them underneath the photo. So you're gonna see me lift that part of the photo up there in the upper right hand corner after I gather up all these stems and then try to get it up underneath here. So it was just the craziest thing. So I left this process in there to show you that I forgot, and I don't know what I was thinking, and I knew I was supposed to do this. And I totally forgot. That's why, and I was like, oh man. So I had to go back and basically lift that up and glue those stems under there one at a time. And oh my gosh, it's just, I don't know. I should have did it ahead of time, but luckily it turned out right, and it was easy to work with, and I was able to get them all down and pinned down there. And then I got some more of the quilling that I'm going to be making, putting over here, so part of the flowers and things like that. So you can see me struggling, and I left this in there. It's a struggle, you guys. It's a real struggle. as you can see. We're not perfect. We never are perfect, especially if we're doing YouTube videos. I know it seems like we are, and we've done everything perfect when we, you know, by the time we finish doing all of our editing, of course, which that's the behind the scenes that nobody sees, but we're not perfect. We are really not perfect. And you can see, they're all sticking up, as you can see. They're sticking up all directions right now because I didn't really get them under there. So I'm cutting off the excess because that is going to go underneath the photo. So I kind of pretty much just shove them under there. I do eventually get them under there and I get it right. And then I ended up putting some more glue. And then I was like, oh my gosh, I should have remembered to put these underneath, but I just didn't. And I don't know what I was thinking at the time, but you know, you get so excited. I was so excited because I knew exactly in my mind how I wanted this layout to turn out. And I got overzealous, I should say. Overzealous. But I end up getting them all down. And I'm going to show you a trick that I use to basically to get those stems to bend to my will. You really have to have a really good glue. And this crafter's glue is a good glue. And so it did help me to be able to get those down there. And as you can see, I started bending them to my will and start gluing them down once they were glued. And it just turned out it worked. I was really happy. And I got them all glued down. So you can see me doing that process right here. And you want to make sure that when you do something like this, that you have the stems going the different directions, because you know, in real life, that's exactly how they look. They go in all different directions. Nothing is ever perfect in nature. So you can see that. So you can see me, I have them all nicely curled there, and I loved it. And like I said, the quilling of this cardstock was very easy. It wasn't stiff. It was very good. It's strong cardstock, but at the same time, you can have it do what you want it to do. In other words, have it bend to your will or whatever you want to do. And it's very forgiving, and I love that about it, because I have never worked with cardstock like this. This is unbelievable, so I don't know. There's the secret. What's the secret? Oh my goodness. So once you see me get them all glued down here, then I'm going to add the quilled pieces of the rest of the flower on here, of course, as well, like I did to the other side. So now it's all glued down. I'm going to get them all down there and then start putting down the quilled part of the flowers. And I'm just making sure that stays. And believe it or not, I love this. I love this whole process. Even though I messed up over here on this side, I still love the whole process. The process of just getting it down here and getting it glued, and the twirling of the paper, the cardstock, and I mean, I love this whole entire process, and I'm really happy with that. A little bit about the photo. That photo is of me and my former co-workers, who we were all California co-workers because our company was based out of Oregon. And so we would go up to, let's think of these, Redmond, Oregon, to a company type of training slash retreat. And we would be up there for almost a week, and we'd have a good time. I think it was like 3 days, 4 days. I don't remember, but I do remember that we had a ball each and every time we went up there. It was really nice up there. So that's what the photo is. And then we all had sunglasses that day, and we were all dressed in pretty much the same colors. And so we decided to do the fun thing and mess around with the camera. And yes, we posed as Charlie's Angels. I know. I laugh now, but that was pretty funny. And if any of you do not know who Charlie's Angels are, well, just basically you can Google them. You can Google them, and not the new ones with Drew Barrymore and Lucy, what was that, Lucy Liu, and the other Charlie's Angels, the ones with Kate Jackson, Farrah Fawcett, and Jacqueline Smith. Oh my God, I can't believe I remember all of those guys. Oh my goodness. Anyway, so back to the layout here. I am putting down some pearls here to kind of offset the layout and give it a little bit more like real, I don't know, just a little extra something something, I would say. And I love these pearls. I've had these pearls in my stash, I'm not gonna tell you, but they've been in there for a long time. And so what I'm finding out is that I'm loving creating my own embellishments with this cardstock, my own backgrounds, and you're going to see a lot more coming from me using a lot more of my imagination to use this cardstock to do what I would like for it to do. And yes, there's going to be some times when I will be sending it through my Silhouette machine, because I know there's a few people who are wondering, how does it do with a Silhouette machine? It does perfectly fine. I've done some stuff with it already, and I'll be doing some layouts as well using my Silhouette machine. So you'll get to see that. Right now I am finishing up gluing all these little pearls down, and it does look a lot better once I get those pearls down. And I'm using the glue because the sticky on those pearls isn't as sticky as it was when I first bought those pearls, because they've been in my stash for a few years there. So that's why I use and glued each and every one of them down. So right now I think I am getting, and you don't want to know what my desk looks like right about now, but it's a mess. So now I'm trying to choose a font. I originally chose this font, and I've had this font in my stash forever, and it's called Rain Boots. I really like the way this font looked. I really wanted to use it, but I didn't have all the letters that I need. And you're going to see me kind of mess around with that and figure out, oh my gosh, I don't have everything. Even though I have two sheets right here of these thickers with some letters on it, I used to use these a lot, Rain Boots, I think. I think these are like maybe the fourth and fifth packages of those Rain Boots that I've had, because I've used them in the past quite a bit. So, but I didn't have all the thickers that I needed to spell out what I wanted to spell out, which was us gals. So I'm going to flip through here for a minute. And in the meantime, I am going to ask you, and maybe you can answer your question real quick. What is the oldest thicker font that you have in your stash? Yes, that right there that you see right there is another old thickers font that I have. It's amazing how old some of these thickers are. I remember giving away 25, and I say 25 because I'm being, you know, it might have been a little bit more, of these thickers away to a preschool for the teachers. And most of them, I would say more than half, were full, because that's how many thickers I've had. Now I have not given away thickers, and I have way more thickers than I have space for. So I really just stopped buying thickers until I get some of these things used up. And so, oh, sorry, that's my snack there. My hubby there just dropped off some cookies for me to have. My favorite chocolate chip cookies from Sprouts. Anyway, so what I have, way more thickers than I have space, and so I am not purchasing thickers anymore, you guys. I'm just not going to do it. So I need to get rid of what I have, because I don't want to give you a number, because I don't want to scare people, but I have close to a lot. Okay, all right, so back to the layout. I found part of the font gals there, and I'm also going to put some of these pearls at the bottom so that I can have that focus down in the bottom, because it was missing a little something down there. I was going to put a flower, and in hindsight, I probably should have, because I couldn't find them though, because right now my island desk looks a mess. It's a huge mess, so I really didn't want to look for them, so I just decided to go ahead and put down the pearls. I did eventually find the flower, and you'll see at the end of the pictures, and I was supposed to put two flowers, one at the top and one at the corner, but it's okay. You'll see at the end that I managed to get a flower on the layout anyway. Alrighty, so I think, I'm not sure where I went right now. Oh, I know where I went. I went to go grab another, there I am, with another font. Those are another older thickers. They are the foam ones. And because I wanted that like kind of cool writing there, that fancy scripto kind of type of deal writing, or calligraphy I should say. And so I had to get another font to put it up there. So now it's done. And then right above that, once I get finished, right above that, I was supposed to put a set of flowers. And for some reason, I ended up not being able to find them until after I was done with the entire video. And but I did put them up there eventually. So, and that is that on the thickers, and that's the font. So I got two different fonts on here. One is pretty thick and one is a little thinner. So that is the title, Us Gals. And I'm punching in a little bit of a notch up here because I'm going to be gluing in the back a space for the journaling card. When I have layouts that are heavily focused on the design of the layout, I do end up putting a journaling card on the back. I've done this many, many times before because I want to showcase the layout more so than the journaling part of it. So, and with the photo. So that's why I put the journaling on the back, and that little notch is so that I could put the little card, because I usually put a tag, and that's what I'm going to be journaling on, a tag, and I'm going to be putting the tag back there after I've taken the photos and things like that. So yeah, that's what I do, and that's how I do that. So that's pretty easy, and it stays there, it never moves, so you could slide the tag in and out very easily. And I'm just making sure it's straight, and I didn't get it quite straight, so I'm going to cut a little bit off the edge there. But yeah, that's how I do that. So I am pretty much done with this layout. Like I said, at the end, you're gonna see where I added the flowers and stuff. And then I'm also gonna add some black sprinkles on here, a little bit of light of the black sprinkles. And if you're wanting to know, the Heidi Swap Mist does dry very well on the cardstock as well. So of course you gotta leave it to let it dry for a little bit, just like anything else, but it dries very good on here. So that is pretty much it on the layout there that you can see. And now I'm probably reaching for the mist and everything. So I want to thank you guys for watching, and I want you to make sure that you do. I will leave the link at the bottom there for Cut Cardstock, and that way you can go ahead and look and see what they have. They have so many colors and all kinds of variety of cardstock. So I want to thank you guys so much once again for watching. And take care and have a great and wonderful scrappy week. Bye-bye, guys.